Hello there, my name is Princely, and welcome to my channel, and today I'm playing a game called Firewatch. Now, a little behind the scenes, I've tried to record this game 3 times, and each time something happened with the gameplay to where I just could not use it. Like, this has been the most frustrating experience I've ever had. And it sucks, because I really like this game. I've been interested in it ever since I saw it came out. Ever since it came out and I saw other people play it, which is luckily enough a while ago, so I kind of forgot everything, but I still kind of remember, you know, little bits and pieces here and there. But I gave the forewarning because, as I said, I played this 3 times, so I put in about an hour and got to like the same points each time. This is gonna be like the 3rd, 4th, 5th time I've seen the same stuff over and over again. So, you know, forgive me if my reactions or my commentary or whatever is dull or sped past. I'm gonna try to just kind of flush through it so I can get to the rest of the story. Anyways, I'm bad at introduction, so let's just jump right into it, shall we? Sure, my phone is on. Boulder, Colorado, 1975. You see Julia. She's about your age, late 20s, laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. You're drunk. I remember picking this one. She burned me. And this one, she, like, still kind of burned me a little bit. What would I say? If I was drunk? This is closer to what I'm saying. You slur the word major and it smells like cores. You give an awkward smile. Evolutionary biology, she says, and I'm a professor. Cool, you reply. What's yours, she asks. She sniffs the air. Toxicology? And this confused me at first because I didn't know that was her, like, saying it. I thought that was me because it was red. Was that a bird, you ask? She says, definitely. Worried she hurt your feelings, she asks if you want to split a cheeseburger. 1 week later, you are Julia's boyfriend. That's how it works. I got the goods. Ding ding ding. Where am I coming from, by the way? I wonder if there's any detail to that. Do I live in an apartment? Am I coming from some sort of... Where am I at? Oh! But dang. You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. You move in. You share an apartment near the school with the view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Life is always good. Or can be. Julia wants to get a dog. As a scruffy, undersized beagle, Julia is in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's a bad booty. I always picked the same thing. It said Julia wanted to get a dog. Now, I kind of might have thought the idea was good when she presented it to me, but from the forefront, from the get-go, she wanted the dog, so I think it's, you know, let her get the one that she likes. Pick up the beagle, and she names him Bucket. Bucket's a good dog, and a week later, you've totally forgotten about the other one. That just seems so mean every single time I read it. Julia loves him, you love him too. 1979. You talk out on the deck. It's summer. 9:30 p.m. and the heat still radiates off of the high desert. What do you think about kids? She asks. Kids? They're not very smart or good at much. I'm saying if you and I have some, a couple of idiots. I always say the same thing as well. That would be pretty good. In that case, we should probably get married. Yeah, I would like that, you say. These kids are going to be screwed up enough. It's probably for the best if their parents are hitched. You say she's absolutely right. I love children. I love babies. Like, I have nothing bad to say about children at all. I don't care about poops. I don't care about throw-ups. I don't care about the crazy screams, the no sleep. Hey, like, you can deal with every other unfortunate event in life, but that's the one thing that, like, people have trouble with? Nah. Nah, son. I love babies. Yeah, come on back. Thoroughfare, trailerhead, new point. Oh, look, what is that? A rabbit's paw? I make that joke every single time. But I have to. It's such a good one. 1980. It's a Thursday night and Julia is 4 hours late. She does a call, you're worried and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. Time, you fight when she gets between the sheets. Now, I always pick you get mad because I felt, well, I still feel like it's rude to just ignore somebody. But I'm gonna pick it this time, just because I'm half and half, see what happens. You don't touch each other all night. The next day, you feel guilty for being so angry and ask her about her evening. She says it was great. You hold on to a tiny pill of resentment. You make some coffee and go to work. Oh. That's kind of passive aggressive. Julia still likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. Again, I'm a pose and flex like He-Man, because I'm a He-Man. I'm a strong man. I got the muscles. You look awesome. I agree. I really enjoy that little melody that they got going. It's really soothing. Ah, look at the birds. 1992. During the summers, you and Julia enjoy walking Bucket at night. There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. I already know what to do. Bucket gets kicked. F! Dog! Julia yells. She is flustered and has trouble speaking when she is stressed. You confront the attacker.
Yeah, sir.
Put him up. You beat his goddamn face in, except you scare him away instead. You reach into your pocket like you've got a gun and threaten to kill him. You manage to scare all three of them. He runs away. Julia asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say okay. You don't want to go that way either. Then on, you walk by the river. River's nice. It's a cool breeze. Dog gets to pee. Plan to have kids gets waylaid by work. Sucks every time I read it. That's one thing I hope does not happen to me. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job, associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. I usually pick agree if she can use back and forth. Cause this seems very, very selfish. Like sometimes in life you can be selfish, but for this is, you know, situation, my wife, she wants to do this. It's a great opportunity. Commuting is hard, but, you know, life is hard. I've been giving it a good. She'll love me for forever. You ask her if she'll commute back and forth. You don't want to move to Connecticut. She says that'll be hard, but she'll do it if you won't move. You tell her not to pass it up if it's what she wants. She agrees. She flies back to Boulder 3 times each semester. I personally don't need to see anybody more than 3 times a year. Julia is sent home from Yale on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairwell. He said that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it. After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they are worried that Julia might be suffering from early onset dementia. She is 41. This is something I had an issue with. I don't know if I'm counting wrong or not, but it said, like, when we first, you know, saw each other, we were both in our late 20s. And that was like 1975. It's 88, right? So that's 13 years later. Oh, well, I'll say it. Okay, it's 28, 29. We would be like around. Is it 1985 or 1988? I'll see the next jump. Close your eyes, kiddies. You're about to see a naked man. Woo! King Beef. Yikes. Bucket is getting older. Julia comments that it's kind of nice because he gets in less trouble around the house. A week later, she goes back to the university. Yeah, it was 1985, so not enough time had passed for her to be 41. Like, it had to be like 1985, 1986, or something like that. I met her in 1975, we were in the late 20s. So that's 10 years later, she would have been 30, at least 37, 38. That was, somebody miscalculated the age on that, on math, I guess. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason, and has to be brought home by the police. She is devastated. She is sent home on permanent medical leave. Some days you get to Julia, who calls you a dope, and your unborn children little idiots. Heartstrings! I didn't get to have kids! Other days you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family, they are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. Ah, 1988. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel the nurse. That sucks that I'm like that as a person. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else. Someone with 24-hour care. A home. It sits with you for a couple of months. Yeah, like... I guess go with the flow of the story. This guy... He wants to love his wife, but he's finding it difficult... To do that. You decide to move her into a full-time care facility. You are determined to take care of her by yourself. This, to me, is unrealistic. You don't know anything about onset dementia. You might have read like a few books because she has that affliction, but like, you're not a professional, and it's obvious that you're frustrated by it. And I'd hate to, if I was put in that situation, just come to resent my wife over, you know, something that she has no control over. So. Facility. Like, it seems embarrassing or whatever, but hey man, that's life. Whee! So majestic. Her family agrees with your decision. Find a fantastic place in Boulder and move her there. You see her every day and every other day. Yeah. You go out to the bar with your old friends. It's not the same. You get the feeling that every wife tells her husband, if you ever put me in a home like Henry did, I'll cut your balls off. You slowly decide to not see your old friends that much. Why do you keep going out with your old friends? Wait, maybe they're just telling them that. Because, the way it was written, it made it seem like he was going out with his old friends and their wives. Like, that must be just, awkward. Julia's sister Susan moves to Boulder to be close to her. She visits her every day. You go with her some of the time. Susan buys you an old typewriter and urges you to use it if you won't see a therapist. You won't. Again, this is like his id coming out, like I can't change that. You've always really liked Susan. Months go by, Bucket dies. Julia doesn't remember him when you tell her. Sometimes it takes her a minute to lock in on you. In the back of your mind, you believe it's because you see her less and less. And seeing her less and less makes her forget you more, you think. Summer is coming and you see an ad in the paper for a job. You take it. I don't truly like judging people, but this guy... He doesn't seem like too good of a guy. I know that's harsh and everything, but... And I guess to be fair, like, it was never said at any point in time that you're playing a hero. I guess it's supposed to be. Of course, you're supposed to be playing a, like, you know, just a regular old human being, a human male. Uh-oh, game is glitching a little bit. Smack!
Hello, Two Forks Tower.
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
Hey there, Delilah.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. How does she... no, go ahead.
How does she see the lights? This place is boarded up. Was she looking at me? Creep.
Okay, you've killed 3 husbands. You're a black widow and you're just out here until the heat dies down and then you'll kill again.
Imaginative.
Ooh, very good. Bravo, Henry.
Thank you.
Okay, I sleep now?
Not quite. Now you.
Okay, good night. Bye.
Let's see. I don't know anything about you, but 9 times out of 10, folks out here simply got dumped.
Huh, is that it?
Dumped.
Close?
Good night.
Good night. Welcome to the job.
Wait, no! I want to turn off the lamp! No! I'm wasting power! My electricity bill! She was a goof. Yeah, I kinda... From the get-go, I saw the, you know, the arc that was gonna be happening with Delilah. Yeah, they make her give this bombastic personality that kinda... It's supposed to be, like, irritating, but it's also endearing in a way, I guess. But I'm not a cheater! I don't care what's happening with my wife. I'm married. I got the ring.
Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon.
I'm not gonna cheat.
You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
Jesus.
Hey, sorry. Guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, what, 14 hours of sleep? Whew.
Yeah, Jesus, I guess it's, what, 6?
Pretty little thing.
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Yep.
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This thing.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing language. Window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing? Are those fucking fireworks?
Oh, west. This way. Yes.
Whoa,
those are fireworks.
That's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is.
What?
The closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set them straight.
Grumble at you.
I'm not really a disciplinarian type of guy.
Well, make them knock it off without smoking a joint with them, okay?
Sure. All right.
Now what I meant.
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right.
Mm-hmm.
There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
This map is so freaking hard to read. Smart.
Shut up.
Shut up. Alright, let's get going. Every single time I do this part, I get lost. Because I'm like, looking at it, I'm like, this map doesn't make no sense. I think I got it this time, though. Onward! I'm trying to push through everything, but I'm a bit of a explorationist. I love to look at everything. I love to listen to all conversations. So there's going to be a lot of that. Four, the most secure. Was it a note?
Hey, I found a note to a guy named Ron from some guy Dave.
That's probably Dave Gaskell. He's completely nuts.
Is that right?
Harmless, but yeah, one of those, you know, fall off the grid and eat ants for a week type. Totally fucking cuckoo. Which is kind of what the job attracts.
There we go.
I tracked down that rope. It was right where you said.
Nice.
Great. So you should be set to get down to the lake.
Mm-hmm. And the bar.
People just stuff these things with old food?
Eat
That's
it.
How you get bears.
Those boxes are bear-proof. I wouldn't worry about it.
This box... Bear-proof. Yeah, it's bear-proof because bears don't exist in this game. I'm gonna go this way. Those rockets sound like actual rockets. Or the fireworks sound like actual rockets. Onward. Last time I played, I took the boombox. Well, you see. I'll show you. I'm not gonna do the same thing I did last time because it was actually quite annoying.
Hey, there's a tree out here that's been ripped to hell.
Ooh.
And?
Don't you think that's, you know, like, disconcerting?
Henry, there are 500-pound grizzly bears out here. They sharpen their claws on trees.
We don't have grizzlies in Colorado. People killed them a long time ago.
Well, in the thoroughfare, they hunt people, they kill people, they bury their bodies, and then come back weeks later to eat them because they prefer rotten meat.
Ooh.
People just disappear.
Don't you think that's disconcerting?
No, Henry, that's life.
Yep.
Christ, lady.
Jesus Christ, lady. It's gonna... Wait.
This shale slide is steep.
I wanna give it a name.
How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
Maybe call the Cripple Goats. That goes Widowmaker. What about Poopy Boss is going to get me killed, Hill?
It should be called Cripple Gulch, just east of Gonna Pee in a Bag Forever Flats.
Oh, is that Absorca Indian? Maybe Creek?
That's actually English for not in my job description.
Woo! Is there anything else? Just how do I get down? Nah, I don't know how to get down. Rappel! Dave Rappel! On the road again. Crack, crack, crack. All bones broken in my neck. Oh, my candy bar.
Hey.
Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
Cripple Gulch got me.
What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
Think you'll have to pee in a bag for the rest of your life?
No, I think I'll make it.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
Chris' sake.
Hey, there's a tie-off point off here just a little way from the shale slide.
Can I go down?
Well, you're ready to get back on that horse, huh?
I can't go any further is what I'm saying.
That heads south down to the creek, but you should be able to get to the lake just by continuing west. Without any, you know, mountaineering.
All right.
It's a long summer. You can explore later.
Wow, there's a big rock outcropping down here near the lake. It's really something.
Yeah, makes for good camping. There used to be a group of guys who would boulder out there a couple times a year.
What happened to them?
Boulder.
Dunno. Just stop coming out?
Look at all these beers.
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans. They threw them all over hell.
The idiots down at the lake?
What do you know? People with shitty manners drink shitty beer.
What, you don't like a cold Musquelite on a hot day?
No, I do. But then again, I didn't say my manners were any good. Better than these fucking litter bugs, though, that's for sure.
Talk about her. Woo! Boy, language, brother. Language. I like to keep a clean nature as well.
Oh shit.
Whiskey!
You left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Taking it.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
Oh look, they decided to have a campfire too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't take into account just plain stupid, does it?
They left their packs tied up here.
Don't fuck with them. The last thing we need is some hikers filing a report about harassment.
Ooh, fireworks.
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
I better get a trophy for cleaning up all these goddamn cans. I do it every single time just because I have to. I can't leave them cans out here. What if a platypus walked upon them and said, "Hey, what's that?" and decided to shove it down its mouth and choked it death? I wouldn't care. Platypus, platypi. That's my song.
I found a bra.
A newbie pyromaniac. Yeah. Remain professional.
There are...
Panties. Panties.
There are what?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
There's a... Ooh.
Yes?
There are two naked ladies out here.
Can you handle that?
Come on, I like naked ladies same as anyone, but there's, you know...
Two?
Yeah.
I know this will be tough for you, but try to pick your tongue up off the ground and do your job.
Okay. I found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping?
Yeah.
Is that a guy over there?
Oh boy. Enjoy dealing with that.
You gotta take it easy with the fireworks, alright?
You ought to take it easy at the Sizzler Buffet.
Grody!
All the way out here to get away from guys like you.
Look, I'm sorry for bothering you. Can you just knock it off, please?
Yeah, you should be. This is a free country, and we should be free to do whatever we want.
And free from any peeping Tom.
I said sorry.
Oh my God, is that what you are?
Ugh. They always say the same thing in the end.
Hey, that go okay?
It went fine. I.
Oh, wow. The music's a little loud.
Oh, sorry. I took their stereo.
Okay, well, I guess we're all even.
Nah, I'm not going.
Yeah, I think so.
But seriously, though, thanks for dealing with it.
Ah! Da-da-da-da-da! Just push play. If you only knew how I feel about you, baby. Jonesy Lake.
Well, this lake does seem like a good spot to swim,
mm-hmm.
Even if the last people to do so were assholes.
Yeah, right now, though, it's all snowmelt, so you'll freeze your balls off. But as hot as it's
been,
maybe that's a fair trade.
Starting to feel like it.
Give me them goods. What you got for me? Nice. No
Fireworks!
Ron, got some bad news back at home, so hopefully they'll let me out of here for a while. Who's to say, though, budgets being what they are? Did you get my note about what went down in Wapiti? Sheriff is too pleased with me, but I don't know. I probably overdid it. Wish he would have been there. I guess he must have got hung up. Dash Dave. P.S. Amigos is Spanish, and Profesionales is Italian. Nice.
Keeping it.
I found a sweatshirt from the University of Eastern Colorado.
Colorado.
There's the University of Eastern Colorado?
I really don't think there is.
Yeah.
Why would somebody make that up?
Right, and then put it on a sweatshirt.
No.
The world's a weird place.
Yeah. Yes. Wait, that's a game that I got out of there? Oh, I want that boombox, but like the song repeats over and over and over and over again. I got a while before I get back to the place, so.
Any chance of those kids getting a disease in this lake, like diphtheria or consumption or...
Consumption? Not if they're not 19th century chimney sweeps.
No.
You know, whatever.
I mean, if they drank a bunch, Giardia maybe, but probably not this time of year.
That's too bad.
It's mean. It's, they're just some teenage girls. You know how teenage girls can be. They got smart mouths. Like whips. Turn it up! Turn it up! Turn it up!
Just push play!
Give me that! Alright. Look at them rocks.
So, I have a bit of a confession to make.
What is it?
I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Woo!
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum.
No, you won't.
Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
Oh, I can see my tower from far away.
Yeah, we experimented with hidden underground towers for a while, but we weren't really happy with the results.
Great. Sarcasm is not going to get old. We're together.
You did not.
No, we didn't. Anyway, happy hiking.
Jesus. Boy. I can't imagine what she looks like. But I know she had very few friends. Uh-oh. Ah!
Hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home, and try not to get hit by lightning.
Yeah, I'm not sure I got a lot of choice in getting struck down.
Yeah.
Especially not with your electric personality.
Oof.
Ugh.
I see my joke did not spark your sense of humor.
Ugh.
When you're not enjoying our current
conversation. My god. I never got this far with this.
Oh my god, lady.
The arc of our budding friendship.
How are you in charge?
The entire wilderness in the hands of an insane person. How exactly are you in charge?
Charge, Henry.
Okay, I'm done responding to you. Bye.
I see. DC. ACDC.
I got it!
Goodness gracious, this lady is too much. Like the god. Ooh. Got clear? It said clear. I saw clear. Clear! Clear! Oh, not the. What's over here? Where am I going? I bet I get attacked by the birds. Where the heck am I? Beartooth Point. Oh, dude, what? Can I explore? Is this like a secret area? Please don't let me get attacked by a bear because I'm going to the wrong place.
I just want to see.
I am not a fan of thunder, by the way. I am afraid of it. I'm an adult, so I've been told. Yes, I'm afraid of lightning. I'm afraid of the thunder. It's not my thing. Where am I? Ooh. I don't think I'm supposed to be here. Go for a fire lookout. Oh no. Let's go. Run back. Oh! Thought I heard something. Leave me alone! God, if I turn around, that was just like a bear. Just... 64. Give me them goods. Ooh, a horn.
Yeah, I get the sense that not everything in here is useful.
In the boxes? Why's that?
I found a flashlight.
There's one in there? Great. Well, the sun's gonna go down soon, so if the batteries still work, you're in luck.
I guess I can't take it with me.
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
Hey, I didn't name it. But in the cave? I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous.
So
I say, fuck it. You're a grown man, you can go where you want.
Great. Used to go caving with someone back in Colorado. Mm-hmm. She loved it. Might be great to explore it sometime this summer.
Well, that could be fun. Obviously, be very careful.
In Du Bois, Du Bois.
It doesn't seem that dangerous. Whoa, whoa! Ah, no!
Henry!
Seriously, it's completely fine in here.
God damn it.
That's what you get for all the goddamn sarcasm!
This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Makes sense.
Although, Debbie says she lost them like 3 years ago, so...
Debbie!
Maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
Debbie!
Ah, damn.
Why are you always losing my keys? Caving kicks in.
Oh, this one's so close to home.
I said, Debbie!
Aw, sorry, Hank.
Why are you so allergic to me?
It looks like the path leads through the cave.
Back in the cave, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Man, I don't need to lose another lookout in there.
Another lookout?
Uh-oh.
They go in, they never come out.
This woman.
So this is another one of your jokes.
Yeah, it is. Yep.
Incorrigible. That's what they call people like her. Not too tired to run home. I'm gonna get caught in the middle of a thunder. Ow!
There's hey. Some guy out here.
Hey!
Some guy?
Dude!
Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something something someone should have told you about this area.
What?
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
I gotcha.
Look, bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
This flashlight is dopey. Dopey. Yeah, see? Right now, I would've... In the previously failed video, I would've still had that boombox with me. And it was playing that song on loop the whole time. Like, even I got a little irritated by it. Just a little bit, though, because I really like that song. But I was like, oh, I can't put this in a goddamn video. This would be like if I had a horn and was like, yeah, I can't do that. My typewriter.
What can I do for you?
Scary music.
Well, my typewriter is on the ground outside of my tower.
You right?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell?
You should get inside.
Fuck me.
Wait, what? Skip some dialogue, I think.
Someone broke in.
Hey, what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker.
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
First, picture of my wife. Put back. Now I straighten up all these goddamn bucks. Wrong with you, sir. What are you looking for? Look at this. You took my sheets.
My sheets are gone.
They stole your sheets? That's just mean.
Yeah, it sucks.
Okay, I put in a call.
That was fast.
Yeah, well, do you have any idea who could have done this?
Dang it.
I did.
No, dang.
With the lake. Fuck them.
Not what I meant.
Well, I'll have the rangers keep an eye out for a couple of young women and question
no.
any they find.
No.
I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some, what, violent campers? Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes
He rumpled my rug!
I need Busted. You to feel safe out here.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, you can protect yourself, huh?
I'm a man.
I just don't worry about it.
Perfect. Keep that attitude up, and you'll have an excellent summer.
Thank you.
Wake up. Hey, wake up.
Wait a minute.
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case.
Can I go fix it?
Well, you probably can't, but what you can do is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
Henry.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, all right.
Okay. So I'm gonna end the video there. I hope you enjoyed. Oh, boy. I'm so glad I got to that. I took probably like 5-6 minutes less than I usually did to do it. But man. I hope that this one you're able to see this. If not, I'll probably end up doing it again because I really like this game and I really want to play it for my channel. But hey, if you liked the video, let me know why. If you did not like the video, let me know why. I'd appreciate you coming by, stopping by, looking at the video, viewing however long you viewed, all that good stuff. And hey, to the next video. Bye.